Now, I want to share with you a very quick story about my life. When I had broached to my wife and my daughter that I wanted to be a pastor, both had their reservations, and quite honestly, that's what needed to have done. So we decided to take a visit to Concordia Seminary in St. Louis, and that's where I went. I graduated in 1996. And so we drove there, and the first word out of my daughter's mouth as we pulled into the campus, she goes, "Oh, I like this," which from the front seats in the car was a very big sigh of relief. But the interesting thing about that story was, and she relayed this to me years later, and that was, I was afraid they were going to change my dad. That my dad was going to be walking around in, you know, like a priest would walk around. If you ever watched the show Father Brown, you know, he's always wearing the cassock. He's always wearing the black shirt with a white tab. He's always, always, always in priest mode. And she was afraid that her father was going to turn into priest mode. He was going to change who he was. And she was so glad that there was a lot of guys out there that were just kind of normal guys preparing to become pastors. And so what Paul is saying is, and we're going to get into starting with verse 13 of chapter 1 of Galatians, Paul is going to be describing his history pre-conversion to Christianity, pre-convicting to Christianity. We're going to get into that and how that Paul's fundamental personality did not change, but how God used that in the conversion process. Looking for more? Absolutely. We'll go with more. And on the other side of the break in today's episode of The Word. We'll be right back.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto.
So in today's episode of The Word, we're going to see from Paul's experience, Paul's going to give his testimony to the church in Galatia and thereby giving his testimony to you and me about your life, his life in Christ, pre-Christ and after conversion to Christ. He's going to give that story. He's also going to give an indication of where he is in his personality and how that didn't change. We're going to get into that. So grab your Bible, please, and we will start right there at verse 13 in Galatians chapter 1. We're going to take a chunk. We're going to go all the way to 17. It's not the end of Paul's testimony, but it's a good breaking point. So 13 to 17, we'll be back on the other side of this break. Okay, here we go. Galatians chapter 1, beginning at verse 13. For you have heard of my former life in Judaism, how I persecuted the church of God violently and tried to destroy it. As I was advancing in Judaism beyond many of my own age among my people, so extremely zealous was I for the traditions of my fathers. But when he who had set me apart before I was born, and who called me by his grace, was pleased to reveal his son to me in order that I might preach him among the Gentiles, I did not immediately consult with anyone, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to those who were apostles before me, but I went into Arabia and returned again to Damascus. So my opening story talks about how my daughter was worried about how I would fundamentally change my actual behavior patterns and change who I was. And Paul is describing, not I'm changing my personality, but what Paul is describing is I'm changing for whom and for what am I using my personality. Paul used the word, and let's look for it. It is in verse 14, starting there. And I was advancing in Judaism beyond many of my own age among my people, so extremely zealous was I for the traditions of my fathers. Paul is extremely zealous, now not for the tradition of his fathers, not for Judaism, but for Christ. So God is taking this person by the name of Saul, originally, now Paul, and he is taking this man, who he is, his entire makeup, and converting the focus of his life. That's the key element, the conversion of the focus of life. Why am I? It's not why am I doing this? No, it's for whom am I doing this? So maybe a question that you can ask of yourselves is this: how is God using me? And this is my personality type, or this is my ways of acting. How is God using that? Not to amplify myself or things that I hold dear, but how is God using that to amplify my life in Christ? You see the difference. It's for whom are we being zealous? And again, Paul's case is, I am extremely zealous for the traditions of my father. But when he who had set me apart before I was born and who called me by his grace was pleased to reveal his son to me in order that I might preach him among the Gentiles, I did not immediately consult with anyone. And then he goes on with the rest of his story, in which we will continue, because the rest of Paul's story is a very good one for all of us. So consider yourself, this is part one of your connection to Paul's story. Bottom line here, that's what I want to get to today. The bottom line is, God, when he converts you to Christianity, is not saying you need to change how you do things and how you think and how you act. No. I just need you to use a different focus. Turn your energies and your personalities towards me versus you. Let me ask you one last question, and I will wrap up our time with this. For what do you have a passion? What are you passionate about? You don't have to tell me. But what I'm looking for from you is some dialogue on how is God taking that passion, not the for what, but the passion, and using that to do for what? For him. See what I'm getting at? And if there's any questions, you can please comment below. That would be great. I'd love to know what you're thinking in this area. You know, I'm, for example, let me use it this way. When I was growing up, my mother would kind of semi-chastise me because I knew every player on the Cleveland Browns roster just by the number on their uniform. Now, this is back in the day that they did not have their names on the uniforms. All they had was a number. For example, number 72 is Jerry Shirk. Number 71 was Walter Johnson. Number 22 was Clarence Scott. Number 27 was Tom Darden. You see, I still know these numbers. My mother was kind of chagrined about that. It's because I knew that better than my math lessons, because I always had a problem with mathematics. So, what is your passion? And for what can you turn that passion into a relationship with Jesus? How do you refocus? And that's a God thing. God's going to refocus your attention, because he's going to make you passionate about Jesus. And that's the power of the Holy Spirit. So, Where are you? That's kind of where I want to leave it today. All right. We will be back again tomorrow morning, going into more of Paul's history as he relates his history pre-Christ and after his conversion to the Galatians. He's going to make a point. He's going to use the point. We're going to have to make our way through it. So we'll see you tomorrow. Give us a thumbs up if you like our video. Share it with your friends. See if they would be like this video as well. Use it for them to tell them, hey, you don't have to change who you are, just your focus. So, all right. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a great one, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Bye.